Biden, 2 years later, they're suddenly admitting, yeah, the Hunter Biden laptop is real, it is authentic, and there's some problematic stuff on it. The reason that I think this is so funny is because they could have made this package 2 years ago. They could have made this report, this video 2 years ago, and maybe just like hung out in their drafts folder until all of a sudden they're like, yeah, I guess 2 years later, now that it's, you know, a non-story, now that it won't hurt Democrats, you can go ahead and release it. Well, let's watch it.
We're prepared to subpoena Hunter Biden. We would certainly hope that he would want to come before the committee and clear his name.
Two of Hunter Biden's former business partners, including Tony Bobulinski, who received the email, told CBS News the 10 held by H for the big guy is shorthand for 10% held by Hunter for his father. After the email became public in 2020, the author of the email told the Wall Street Journal Joe Biden was not involved. The author has not responded to CBS News' questions. Mr. Biden has consistently denied knowledge of his son's work or financially benefiting from it.
I've never spoken to my son about overseas.
Last month, Senator Chuck Grassley wrote this letter alleging bank records and financial data showed that Hunter Biden and the president's brother profited from a $5 million wire from a company connected to CEFC, the Chinese energy firm.
They're going to look at every part of the Joe Biden administration.
Doug High is a Republican strategist.
A lot of this is also going to be aggressive on Hunter specifically. We're going to hear a lot about the laptop. Who profited? Was the law broken? Was it not broken?
After 2 years of scrutiny, the laptop has not produced evidence President Biden directly benefited from his son's business deals.
If there's dirt there, that will dirty him up. If not, those attacks can backfire.
The White House declined to comment. Hunter's lawyer did not address our specific questions about the data or the CBS forensic review, but said there have been multiple attempts to hack, infect, distort, and peddle misinformation regarding Mr. Biden's devices and data. And at no time did any individual, including the IT repair shop owner, Mr. McIsaac, have Mr. Biden's consent to access his computer data or share it with others. The lawyer also referred us to Hunter Biden's memoir, where the president's son slammed the despicable opposition that purported to have a laptop belonging to him.
Does that make you laugh or does that make you laugh? I mean, it's not funny because they're liars, but it's so funny. They told us for 2 years that it's fake and then all of a sudden they're saying it's real, but like they don't issue any mea culpa, none. They just ignore the fact that they've told us that we were conspiracy theorists for 2 years. Well, I guess under their own definition now, so are they. Merrick Garland's Department of Justice certainly doesn't care. He's willing to appoint a very problematic, very biased, very corrupt special counsel to investigate Trump, but he doesn't care at all about the current president of the United States and his blatant corruption through his son.